For those of you who don't know, one of my career before I was a presentation guy was I was touring as a lighting technician and later lighting designer. And I was lucky enough to tour with a whole bunch of big rock bands, and it was a very, very important time in my life. And as that reason, for that reason, as cliched as it is, I've decided to start and maybe sharing some of my roadie rules, these kind of things that I picked up when I was touring with these bands way back in the day. And again, I know it's a cliche, but there's some really, really cool shit I learned, and it was a very, very impactful time in my life. So I thought I'd kind of go down memory lane. So I want to start with a story that was about 24 years ago this week. And UB40 was here. There was, I think, the Promises and Lies tour, although the set, I remember being a big kitchen with rats everywhere, so a rat in my kitchen, but anyway. And the tour had started in Durban, then went to Pretoria, and then went down to Cape Town. And we got down to Durban, we'd pre-prepped the whole gig, and it had taken us, I think, maybe a full day's load-in, then we focused throughout the night, and it was ready. So it was like an 18, 19 hour load-in. And that was great, and the show finished that night. We pulled it all down. We were finished at about 8, 9 in the morning, and then we sent the trucks up to Pretoria, and we went round, we got on a plane, we flew up. Now, normally what we'd have expected is by the time we kind of landed there, the trucks would have just been pulling in, and we would have had time to set up. But for some reason, the trucks didn't arrive. And now, this was crazy. We were used to the idea that everything would be waiting, we'd run in, we'd get it set up, but nothing. And there was no cell phones. So truck drivers didn't have cell phones on this day, and there wasn't like GPS. So it wasn't like we could just track the truck. In fact, there was some kind of rumor around that the one promoter who was a competitor to the promoter that put on this tour had actually paid people to maybe get the truck to drive away. But anyway, conspiracy theories aside. Eventually, we were sent to bed. We were told to get some sleep. At about 1 in the morning, we were told that the trucks had been found, and we were to get to Loftus to put up the show. So now, the problem in lighting is that as a lighting technician, you have to have all the gear up in the dark so that you can focus all your lights. This isn't something you can do during the day. So previously, what we'd been given, like, you know, a full day to do, we now had about 4 hours left to make it happen. Strangest thing is, it did. For some reason, and I don't quite understand what happened, everyone just ran, everyone just got their shit together. There was a few extra stage hands, but for the most part, we just managed to get it done in the time that was allotted. Now, this is called Parkinson's Law. Parkinson's Law says the amount of time it will take you to do something is directly proportionate to the amount of time you're given. Now, here's the crazy thing for me. So there that day, we got everything done by about 4 or 5 in the morning. We were focusing or programming the lights. Everything was ready, but we got everything done.
Pretoria, are you feeling Irish? Welcome to the North one more time.
Here's the crazy thing. The next day, we broke it down again. We got on a plane to Cape Town. We waited for the trucks to arrive, and there they arrived in the right amount of time. And then the next day, it took the whole day again. Now, I don't think we were necessarily trying to work slower. Nothing had changed. Theoretically, we'd proven that we could do it in the 4 or 5 hours. And yet, the next time around, back to the kind of full 15, 16, 17, 18 hours. And I've often thought about this, but I realize it's something that it's just kind of a universal truth. And I find that one of my favorite quotes, I guess also from the music industry, is by a guy called Duke Ellington, the jazz musician. And he said this, he said, "I don't need time, what I need is a deadline." The reason I'm sharing this with you is that in Missing Link, this business, deadlines have always been something. The line is, deadlines are sacrosanct, and it's always been something we lived with. And we knew that somebody had to get onto a stage and to deliver a presentation at a specific time, so the idea of us missing a deadline was impossible. We always had to have them. And because of that, this team is able to work through the night, get things done, and we always make it. Like, we never miss it. Never has there been a client standing on a stage and the presentation hasn't been behind them, ever, in the 21 years that the business has been here. But in my new business, LeaderSpeak, it's not the same. You see, it's an online business and there's still presentations, but there's no natural deadline. And as such, we find that we're not working towards them. And as a team, we kind of got together this morning and we were chatting and we realized that we've got to create them. If you're not given a deadline, you have to create deadlines for yourself. And I know maybe this sounds very obvious to those of you who work in industries where that doesn't happen, or where you don't have a kind of rock and roll style deadlines like we have a missing link. But for us, it was a big aha moment, is that we had to start plotting things with deadlines, even if there was nobody waiting. Even if there were no customers waiting, if there was nobody gonna go up on a stage. And you know what? It's lit a fire in us. It's kind of empowered us to get things done. And that's what I guess I wanna implore you. There's so many things in your life that there are no deadlines for. There's that trip, maybe that bucket list trip that you have been talking about doing, or that project that's been kind of running in the back burner of your office for a while, but no one is kind of telling you to get it done. Well, now I am. I'm telling you, I don't want you to get it done. In fact, all I want you to do is to give me a date. I just want to know, what is the date and the deadline of that thing you've been putting off that's going to be a hard and fast rule? I don't even care what the thing is. I only care about the deadline. I want you to sit for 2 minutes, think about the project you're doing, and then think about when you could do it. And here's the tip. Make it slightly shorter. Create urgency from today. If you make the deadline to be something that feels comfortable, then you're not baking urgency in early. But if you move it just a couple of weeks early, or a couple of hours early, depending on what it is you're working on, or a couple of days early, then what you've done is you've kicked off the process with a natural urgency. And urgency is a beautiful, beautiful thing. It's an amazing, amazing tool for getting things done. So that's what it is. Remember the words of Duke Ellington. You don't need time, what you need is a deadline. And I've given you one. Peace.
Yo, what's up? It's Nick from Missing Link. If you dig Rich's video, please subscribe and stay tuned for more. Peace.